Presentations.
That's like a max salary, just take a main for the class.
Yeah.
It's like 1 year, but it seems pretty cool, it's like every month they go out.
I was just gonna go out there and start our movie. No, and I used to, I have that.
Once I learned. I didn't want to go.
We kind of, you know, we also live.
Well, if you don't, you don't have to, but then you go.
Yeah.
All right, I think if you get on course.
You want to go. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's kind of fun.
Hey, you know something like that? Wake up on the.
You see my hand on a shot, he looks good, buddy.
Did you dive?
Nah, you're something like that, I think you're okay. This.
He will. One that I really like. Thank you.
Really?
Oh yeah, it's all stuff.
Little tilt down. Not that I'm having any fun with this or anything.
Something like that.
What could possibly go wrong, Felix?
Nothing.
No.
Absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, right?
I'm looking in Vegas.
This one?
See there. Absolutely nothing. I like the way you think, buddy.
And then you also get up this one.
There you go.
Awesome.
Oh, watch out. That's a tricky one. A little bit of flexibility there. All right. Welcome to group presentations through free creativity and innovation. I'm your host, Mike KP. Welcome to my playground. I look forward to your genius and insight. Are you excited to be here? You don't look excited to be here. I can put you on the webcam and I can show you how excited you don't look to be here. Okay, I believe you now. All right, who's ready for presentations tonight? Who can't wait for this to be over? What are we doing after this? Yeah, I'm going. I got a meeting at 7 a.m. So we're gonna get started. How many different groups are there? I think we have 5 different groups, right? Your group 1.
Okay. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Do you have
yeah.
2?
I'm
we're doing them. Then you can
1, 2.
That would go good for the group saving. Yeah. Right. And then 2, 3, 4, 5. Looks like 5.
Do you have a helmet too?
Oh, you are there. Okay, so I'm just going to assume all the helmets are together.
Yeah.
Make things a little easier. And we'll get started. You know how it works. You get 5 minutes, right? You're probably going to time it. I'm surely going to time it. You're with your genius idea. And, of course, we are streaming live. And part of that is to kind of show up. I've been bragging to the school and all of SCSU and to the SCSU College of Business and Design Innovation Center. So no pressure, but there are eyes watching. We had some people watch on the last live stream. I'll be shamelessly promoting you and your awesomeness across social media. We'll see if anybody from Zahn is watching. I did invite Zahn to review your group presentations in case they saw anything that really they'd like to encourage or they thought had exceptional merit. They may want to kind of provide a little prodding for you to perhaps go further with your concept. As you know, anything that any student groups or student individuals that that have a great idea and a concept, there are a lot of mechanisms here on campus for you to do something with that. There's Entrepreneur Society, the Zahn Innovation Center, there's a number of other student organizations, right? There are very much a campus of entrepreneurship. Innovation. So if you think you're having fun with Route 53, wait till you see what else you can do on campus. So strongly encourage you to explore that if you're interested. I'm going to get out of your way. We're going to get started here. Who's going first?
We got to wait for Bernie.
There you go. We got one on both sides. The stage is yours. right?
Nope.
Is that a question or are you just trying to go first?
I wasn't really sorry. We're talking, and he goes right to his car.
I can't wait to see where the skateboards go. All hell break loose. Have fun.
That would be so cool.
Yeah.
Places. Hey all, we're the VR Cycle Racing Team. My name is Steve and I'm the crew chief. We've also got Chief Engineer Cole. We've got our racers, Mason, Yesenia, Ryan, and Ronell. We're gonna show you a little bit about the VR cycle. And then we're gonna show you some of the reasons why the VR industry is projected to hit the $150 billion mark by 2020. Our riders are gonna demo some of the ways that the cycle can be used. So pay attention to the screen because you'll be seeing what they're seeing. VR helmets on, team. All right, let's have a good show. Mason, start everybody off right with some history.
Mic test. Perfect. The VR cycle. It's an incredible addition to the renowned Sony PlayStation franchise, giving gamers the ability to experience gaming at a whole new level. Gaming at this time isn't very limited in its ability to fully immerse its players on a physical level. Its purpose is to add the immersion of a gamer that is playing any motorcycle-style video game. Steve Nen, the creator of VR Cycle, drew inspiration to this idea when his lovely wife suggested no longer partake in motorcycle due to its perilous nature. His primary intention was to find a less dangerous way to replicate the excitement of riding motorcycles and still have the sensation of controlling and maneuvering a motorcycle. Back to you, Steve.
Way to take those jumps, Mason. All right, next up, we've got Speed Demon Yesenia. He's going to touch on some of the things we learned in class and how we applied them to the project. Easy on those curves, Yesenia.
Mic check. At the time, his vision for the product was unclear, as the technology was not readily available. Yet, as the technology began to expand and Speed's experience within the industry grew, his ideas for the product began to flourish. As the years progressed, his experience helped build. His experience helped build more successful conditions of the VR cycle and developed the product into the three versions that we have today. Now back to you.
Nice recovery, Yesenia. That was awesome. All right, so the third leg will be handled by street racer Ryan. He's going to go more into the detail on the three different models of VR cycle we've got.
Mic check. Okay, so we have developed three versions of the VR cycle. First model, which we call the Delta model, is a purely hand-operated controller. shaped like a set of motorcycle handlebars and includes features such as a wrist cranking throttle and handbrake. Our main model, called the Bravo model, is a full-size standalone motorcycle and would have features that mimic an actual motorcycle. We named our third model the Alpha model, which is our most advanced system and would be similar to that of the Bravo model, but would have additional upgrades such as rumble motors to mimic the feeling of a revving motor. But the best feature of this model is that it allows users to push the limits of virtual reality technology. Now passing back to you, Steve.
Thank you for not killing us all in that one. All right, so next up, Ronel, how about you show us some of the VR cycles out of this world versatility?
Mic check, 1, 2.
Oh, shit, is that Star Wars?
Each member contributed input on the VR cycle, which led to the development of the three versions that we have now. For ratings in the course, we saw the negative implications of stifling creativity, which ultimately caused school versions plateau. We knew that for VR Cycle to thrive in this competitive market, we need to embrace creativity in the workplace and allow members of our team to express ideas openly. How about some music to cruise with? That music you're hearing is a string quartet. Like the Medici Quartet, we came together as a coalition, united in purpose to accomplish a unified goal with all of our musical strengths. Beautiful, isn't it? And now to our chief engineer, Cole, to take us home.
So VR Cycle is a fantastic addition to the Sony PlayStation. Shape what we think of gaming. There's a huge market potential for this product, and we are entering at the perfect time. We took lessons from creativity and innovation and applied them to this concept. We as a team collaborated well together and made the three versions we have today. So this will be on the market in 2016. Get ready to ride.
Did you stay in touch?
Under 5.
Under 5? 456. Yeah, 455. Right in there. Whatever you'd like to do.
How to what?
How to turn on the
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our show Innovation Inc. Like every week, we will present innovative and creative products that will conquer the market of tomorrow. Tonight will be a very special experience and could change your web life, as the inventors say. Please welcome Vivian and Jesse. Thank you. Vivian, you are the inventor of the pump sucker, right?
Right.
And Jesse, you are the engineer that helped her to build the product, right?
Correct.
Please tell us what the puddle sucker is and how it works.
So first of all, thank you for having me again and now us. So maybe you remember the function of the Pulse Sucker from last time when I was in your show.
Yeah.
So the idea was to suck all the water from the floor and then have it in a tank and then so you can recycle. But at that point, I knew it wasn't perfect, so I knew I needed some help. And then I asked my good old friend, Jesse, he's an engineer, if he can help me with that.
Cool. So the puddle sucker is very similar to a vacuum. The puddle sucker has a motor and the turbines are connected to the motor and it spins the turbines, causing the effect of the water being sucked in towards the intake port, which is covered by a dirt filter, so we don't want any of that excess dirt inside the tank.
Right.
When we reuse it, we don't want it on our garden. We also added a sensor to it so that after you're done taking a shower, it automatically begins and it starts sucking in the water so it's completely dry. We also decided to add a non-slip reflector mat in which it would reflect the water off the mat and it'd be more efficient so that the puddle sucker could suck in more easily. We also decided to add some components to it similar to KP's, you know, his camera that they had the adapters to it. We thought it'd be unique to add some adapters to it to get to the harder areas to reach. We also decided to add a tank gauge so that we could use the analysis to see how much water we're really saving. And, you know, just to see, make sure that our tank's not overfilling also. And those are the components to the puddle sucker.
Okay, thank you for this. And now let's have a look to Ersin, our reporter, who's testing this innovation at a customer's house. Ersin, where are you? Okay, thank you, Ersin. Okay, let's see what our innovation barometer says. Unbelievable! The 10 out of 10! That never happened before! Okay, that was nice, Ersin and Celine. Thank you for this. Saving energy and never having wet socks at the same time again sounds like a big deal. And therefore, I got a big surprise for you all. Let's welcome Roberto, the responsible for healthcare and green energy from the US government. Welcome, Roberto!
Well, nowadays, the state of California has a very big water challenge.
Yeah, that's no? Right.
In the last year, the urban water has dropped more than 25%. So, with this innovative and creative product, I think we can deal with it. Mm-hmm. And the government would gladly support you with any type of resources or investments for the sake of all people.
Okay, thank you for this, Roberto. I hope you enjoyed tonight's show, and I hope to see you again next week for the next innovation. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Very good.
Two photos, huh? Yeah.
Jesse.
How long was it? Oh.
So good.
All right, everyone. Hi, my name is Eveen. This is Eva, Claire, and Anna. And today we're going to start with a short clip video.
How
are you?
Good.
I'm in the class. This is from Planet Elizabeth. They need to return it to
get a cost.
Okay,
good.
Why does the
Elizabeth
not hold
up to get cost?
We actually don't bring that shipping cost. So now when I get a new shirt, I have to pay extra $5 for the advance for the shipping cost.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Feel my wings in the dark again. Got to find a big love. I can take it away to turn you, but I know it's all. It's called the Holographic app. It's an app that will help online shoppers to shop online. Right, first you scan yourself. Once you scan yourself, you will be in the app, like a holographic model, and then you're going to go online and shop online and choose the type of cloth that you want. Let's say, for example, you want a shirt. You're going to choose the size and the color. Once you choose the size and the color, it's going to pop up like a small image, and you can stretch it back, forth, right, left. Once you stretch it, you chose the size first, and once you stretch it, there's going to be like an answer machine that tells you, oh, this is the right size for you. Let's say you chose medium. If you stretch it more, it's going to go to a larger size. Once you stretch it to a medium size, you can step in it. Once you step in it, it's going to tell you, oh, it does fit you. But if it doesn't fit you, there's going to be an answer machine that tells you, oh, it's tight for your shoulder or from your back or for your stomach. And all, yeah. So the purpose for this app is that you can try clothes online before you're using it, so you don't need to go to the store and in and out of different rooms. And it's user-friendly, so everyone can use it. You can use it back home. And when you're back home, there's a relaxing area and you feel good, then it's the perfect time to try out the clothes and don't waste a necessary time. And it's perfect for people who don't like to go to the store and don't have the time. So even. For example, a lot of times I buy stuff online and like I said, it doesn't fit me. First I have to pay for the shipping, and when I go return, I ask them, hey, you did refund me the money, but what about the shipping? They said, sorry, we can't refund you the shipping. Right now, when I go back online again, I have to buy the same thing, and I have also to pay like the extra shipping, which is can save me up to 5 pieces and chocolate. Exactly. Or for me, I'm a business student right now with the finance and everything, and I go into a special party next week, and I really need to have a dress that fits me well, and it's perfect to use this app because I know it will fit me and it will be delivered on time.
So let's talk about the target group. So first of all, it's a two-sided market. So it's a cooperation or partnership with the online retailer for clothing. Or it's the online shoppers themselves, so the people who use that app. And our intention is to reach actually all online shoppers with all ages. And yeah, well, and that could be, for example, busy people, so like career women or people or women with little children. Of course, people who just feel uncomfortable to go to stores and try the clothes on. So due to weight problems or they're handicapped or they just think it's not convenient.
Yeah, and as you said, it's a two-sided market. So in a business context, the app should be provided by the App Store where people like us can download it and use it. And it should be sold to web distributors who should pay for having the functions on their website. In that way, the app would actually make profit for us. However, it will also benefit the stores and the web distributors because they would have increased customer satisfaction because customers can try on their clothes before buying them, and they would use less money and effort on returned purchases. That way, they would be better off, and people who are trying the clothes on would be better off, and we would make profit by the app, which would be perfect. So, welcome to Hologram Graphic.
Questions, comments, concerns?
Next up. Stretch out, Bernard. I don't want you to pull a hammy during this presentation.
Thank you. Yes, it was rough.
Just get you back into the groove. It's a shielded social family network separated from Facebook where you can share awesome things with your family. The aim is to attract current non-Facebook users like your grandparents or small children that are under 12 years old. It was supposed to be a design thinking approach, so we took a human-centered approach based on direct observation of our own families. What's important to families when interacting with each other? What do they do at Christmas dinner? What would make grandparents create an account, and why are they not using it currently?
Well, then, what impedes grandparents and children from using Facebook? Parents don't want their children to use the English Facebook because of the advertisement and also because of the pages they can reach. Facebook can be an unlimited potential and direction, and hopefully it doesn't go on a wrong way. Parents want their children to be safe. And then older people don't use Facebook because they think it's a bit complicated. But they would like to use it because one thing, they would like to be connected with their family and friends.
How to attract the users? You only see what your family is posting and nobody else can get into that network. The advertisement will be carefully selected so that only family-friendly ads will show up, so thus making it safe for children.
For all the people, it will be based on ease of use by voice navigation. Furthermore, imagine your grandson comes to you and wants to sit down to set up a family Facebook account with you. You will probably say yes, since spending time with your family is the most valuable thing for them. So they can be guided and helped by their families to get used to it. We'll publish TV commercials like the video in the beginning of the presentation, and it will be based on emotions. When all the people see the commercials with Lily showing her first grade artwork to grandma over the video chat feature, they will love to engage with it. Additionally, this commercial will also pop up when you log into your regular Facebook.
So now we come to the features. One feature will be digital postcards, because that's what many families like to share. By providing a digital postcard, we can have some extra features and opportunities. One thing would be that it can be easily designed and personalized by yourself, making it more interesting and also more cooler than just a traditional corny postcard. Instead of having a rigid picture like on the postcard, it could be a video of you saying, hey, what's up everybody, greetings from the beach, or it could be a picture of you with some audio message. In the back, it will include a text like a traditional postcard, but the thing is that there will be some additional information provided for your grandparents. This happens via a learn about section that will pop up if you click on a hyperlink. This will contain additional information about the place, like things you can do nearby or hotels or restaurants, and this will be sponsored content, thus creating extra revenue for Facebook.
What do all families do when they're together? Exactly, they play games. And that's why we want to provide some common family games like I Spy and Monopoly. And the great thing about it is that in the middle you can see the game, and on the side you can see each player with a video chat. So that way you can actually see when you're enraged father smash the keyboard when he's losing, like him. And by that, you feel way more close to your family compared to regular online games.
We also added Cook Time and Big Exam. Cook Time is you can schedule cooking the same meal and having a place at the dinner table with like your grandparents, like you do a Christmas dinner or Thanksgiving. And Make It Time allows you to schedule family trips. It also has a photo album feature. It's something we looked at that a lot of families do when they're together, is they'll like sit on the couch and grandma will show the grandkid the photo album, like her and grandpa when they were little, or the kids' parents when they were growing up. And that's like a really good memory maker for families. So we're going to have an online feature where you can share photo albums just of your family. And we think that would draw in a lot of people.
All right, so we just want to thank you for your time and wish a good evening for all of you. Thank you.
All right, and our last group.
What was their time?
I think that was all the
that it?
Yeah, I guess
four.
That's it.
Oh, I thought we had five.
Well, time goes.
Right. What was the time?
I thought we had 528.
528?
Yeah.
Woo! Smoking. There you go. Right on the gun.
528. 28.